Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Dirt, Grain, and Steel. We're switching gears a little bit with this video now. We're coming into the 2020 grow season. So I've got the 8640 in our big bladed disc that we usually use for land clearing. We picked up a farm, about 350 acres last fall, and I custom planted it last spring. I started planting it, I got kidney stones, and I had to let my dad finish it. I got 300 acres planted, and then the kidney stones hit me, so the last 50 my dad had to plant, so it kind of took me out of the game. But anyways, fall came around and the landowner said, hey, why don't you guys farm it for me? Because I'm ready to throttle back and retire a little bit. So I said, sure, we'll take it over. So we're heading there right now. We're gonna break ground on our first year of farming it, completely farming it. And I'm pretty excited about it. It's a pretty nice piece of ground. We're gonna probably put some corn and soybeans on it. I haven't quite made up my mind if we're gonna go full corn or full soybeans on it yet. So I'm heading down right now. I'm going to disc some spots that have been left lay for a couple years. They've got a lot of giant ragweed growing on them, or had. A lot of stems and stuff are left. So I'm going to go down there with the 8640 in this big blade disc. We're going to chew those spots up. We're going to go around the fields. We're going to chew up around the fields. Kind of chew the briars back and all that. And Dad's following shortly behind me with the 4955 with the 30-foot 496 disc that we restored this winter. So hope you enjoy this video. Like I said, we're switching gears here a little bit. We're going to the farming side of things. We have been in the excavating and fabricating side of things, which we're going to continue on with those videos. But it's farming season now, so stay tuned. I'm going to make some good videos for you. We're going to follow some crops all the way through. I'm going to pick a couple fields, and we're going to follow those crops all the way through to harvest. We're going to do some yield checks, and we're going to share that with you. We're going to share the varieties. My buddy Keith Werner from Werner Farms, right there in Hanna, Indiana, he's going to give me some Pioneer soybeans to try. We're going to do some yield checks on those against our Beck soybeans. We're going to do those in 30-inch and 15-inch rows. So if you're not familiar with Keith Werner, go over to Werner Farms on YouTube and check him out. He's got some really cool videos. He's got some really cool drone videos and stuff. That's what he does. He does a lot of drone work and stuff like that. So anyways, I'm going to get down to the farm. We've got about an hour riding the tractor. So once I get down there, I'll show you what we're going to do. So we made it down to the new farm. Real quick, what we're going to do here, and give you a little history on the tractor too. So what we're going to do here is, as you can see, we got this low spot here that has these giant ragweed stems on it. That hasn't been farmed in a couple years. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this big blade disc out there, and we're going to disc them up. Stand behind the tractor, get out of the wind so you can hear me. We're going to, we got several patches like this we're going to be discing up and getting them cut up, and then Dad's going to, we're going to actually work the whole entire farm, but we're going to hit these worst spots first and get these taken care of. A little history on the tractor here. It's a, one of the first 100 8640s made. It's an earlier 8640. I got it from a dairy farm. when we got it, it had a failed side stack exhaust attempt done to it. So the hood was all cut out. They did run the exhaust along the firewall, and it melted a lot of the wiring. So I had to redo a bunch of that. When I got it, I didn't realize the clutch was out of it, because it would drive around, and it was cold out today. We went and looked at it and didn't look at it very long. Just drove it around in like B2. I didn't attempt any other gears. Well, I got it home, went to our local John Deere dealer, purchased a ripper. And that spring, I went out and dropped the ripper in the ground, and she come to a stop and just ran wide open. So we discovered that the clutch was out of it. So we brought it back to the shop. We didn't do any ripping that spring. Well, we did do some ripping. I went and got my grandpa's 5-shank ripper and put it behind a 49. Ripped what I wanted to. Got it back to the shop. We took it apart, put a clutch in it, which if anybody's familiar with these tractors, that means splitting a tractor right in front of the cab. You actually unbolt the frame rails and you roll the whole thing, the whole front part forward. The motor stays hanging on the transmission. Unbolt the motor, lift it off of the bobcat or excavator, set it on the floor, then you can do a clutch job on it. So, done that, cleaned her up really good, six new tires on the rear, or six new tires total on it, because six were pretty bad shape. So I put the new tires on it. What else did we do to it? I had to put all new lights on it. I had to get a new hood for it. Went to Worthington Ag Parts, found a good hood. It's not a new hood, of course, but it's a good hood. And put her all back together, squirted a little paint on her here and there. She's my old battle axe. I mean, she's nothing pretty. She's not the tractor you're going to take to the prom, but you take her out here in this stuff, she'll damn near walk on water. So, good old tractor. I've thought about getting rid of it, but then I'm like, no, I'm going to keep it around. I like it too much. It's a little hard shifting now and then, but that was all these old girls there. They're a little temperamental sometimes. I do have the sheet metal that goes between the fenders. I got to fix that. It was pretty beat up when we got the tractor, and I just haven't had time to fix it. But a little history on the disc. I believe it's a 320 John Deere disc. It's got the big notch blades on it. We got it. It looks just like when we got it. It was bought brand new and left outside, like some implements are. When we got it, the blades were practically new on it. We usually mainly use it for just discing after we clear ground, because then blades will really cut up small roots and sticks really nice and level it out. We've had it probably 8 years now, and we use it on applications like this when we really want to tear ground up, because it's kind of like plowing shallow with a moldboard plow. It moves a lot of dirt, and that's what I like about it. But that's really all the history I got on it. I found out that the reason that it was bought was because they were discing alfalfa, and I guess if you disc alfalfa, it promotes it to grow. I don't know. I'm not a hay expert. So that's the story I kind of got on this disc. But anyways, that's just a little history on the old 8640. Don't really know anymore I can tell you about it. I've had it for probably 4 or 5 years now. Had it quite a while, but it needs a cab kit. That's the next thing I'm gonna do. But it does have a 50 series engine in it. The engine's definitely pretty crisp. It runs real good. It's with 7-shank ripper behind it, you can pretty much run 5.5 miles an hour with it. She's got plenty of power. When I do the cab kit, I'm going to do a 50 series cab kit with the brindle brown in it, just to make it look nicer. And then I'm going to put a thicker 50 series floor plate in it to deaden the sound a little from the transmission. But Anyways, I'm going to get started discing here, and we'll get some videos discing. Well, we're out here discing now. You can see how aggressive this disc is. Engines really chew stuff up. Works real nice. We'll get this disc up, and we'll probably bring the 9300 back with the soil finisher. And run it over with the soil finisher real good. And then we'll plant it. But, yeah, it definitely moves dirt and it chews stuff up. There's no way I could ever bring a soil finisher out here. It'd probably plug up pretty quick. So, pretty happy with this disc. Nothing better than a big bladed disc with notched blades, that's for sure. It's working up real nice out here. Well, got a little light. Oh well, steer over again then. But got the other GoPro down there getting some video. But it's working up pretty good. It's gonna lay back out real nice when we go to run the soil finisher over it, make a nice seed bed. But you're probably wondering, you're like, why do you got like a 350 horse tractor pulling a 12 foot disc? Well, this disc pulls hard, and this tractor walks on water, and I was worried it was going to be wet out here, but so far, conditions are fantastic. I'm getting through all these low spots that I thought were going to be wet. Because, like I mentioned, I had drilled beans on this. Well, I didn't drill them. I air seeded them on this farm last spring, and it was wet right here, and I couldn't get over it. Well, I shouldn't say I couldn't get over it. It wasn't prepared, so I didn't even mess with planting this right here. I just went around it because I was told it'd be wet. So, the gentleman that owns it only has a two-wheel drive tractor, so he just played it safe and stayed out of it. If I would have brought the 8640 down here or the 9300 or something, I could have probably got it worked, but it was already late in the spring and just wanted to get planted what we could. And like I said, I got hit with that case of kidney stones, and that kind of put me out of commission for about 2 or 3 days. That was probably the most pain I've ever been in. It was pretty interesting. I thought I just had a cramp in my back. I was running the hoe, digging a pond, and I thought I had just a cramp from either being hungry or pinched nerve in my back. And that turned into kidney stones, and that was a rough go. Kind of got a history of it in my family. My dad had them and stuff, but I had never had them. And supposedly sweet tea is what caused them. And since then, I quit drinking so much sweet tea. So, but yeah, if you've never had kidney stones, you're in for a quite the treat. But anyways, that's a little bit of medical history probably y'all didn't want to know about, but I shared it anyways. When I first decided to start this YouTube channel, I decided that I wasn't going to hold anything back. I was going to tell the truth all the time and tell you about real life scenarios. And I would say kidney stones is a real life scenario that I'm sure somebody watching out there can relate to and know how it can be. But anyways, I'm gonna keep discing, see if I can't knock this patch out tonight yet. Dad should be down here any minute with the 4955 and the other disc. he's actually going to start discing pretty much the whole farm. And then after that, we're going to run soil finisher over it, try to level it out a little bit. It's got some ridges and some spots that we want to get rid of, because we like to keep nice, smooth fields. But anyways, if you're liking this video so far, you know what to do. Give me a like and a subscribe. And if you want to leave a comment or a question, that's perfectly fine too. I love answering them. So I just got confirmation that my order of soybeans will be here. Keith Werner texted me and told me my soybeans will be here next week. So between them and the bucks, I've got all my seed on its way. So as soon as we're done doing some tillage work, I'm going to get my 30-foot air seeder hooked up to the 4955, and we're going to blow some beans in the ground. Really excited. I can't wait. I think probably my favorite part of spring is probably planting beans. So I'm the bean guy. Dad's the corn guy. So I do all the beans. Dad does all the corn. Been like that for the past probably 8 years now. I've planted all the beans. But anyways, I'm gonna keep discing. I seen I got a surface drain over there coming up, so I'm gonna have to disc around that. But anyways, thanks for watching so far. Greatly appreciate it. We found us a little water out here. You know, these old four-wheel drive articulated 30, 40, and 50 series Deeres get a bad rap because they're hard to work on, clutch issues, training issues, stuff like that. But I'll tell you what, they'll walk on water. They're the right combination of horsepower, right combination of weight. And I'll tell you what, you can go through some pretty nasty stuff with them. If it wasn't for this tractor last spring, there's a lot of ground I wouldn't have got over and got dried out. Now you can see why I don't really want to get rid of this tractor, because it'll go anywhere pretty much. I think there's a slight compaction issue in this area right here. We're gonna have to probably get the ripper out here, get this dried out, get the ripper out here, and see if we can't do a little ripping, because that's a little excessive. I think we're going to do some tiling either this spring yet, or next fall, get that area fixed, because that disc keeps plugging up. It's so slick out here. But yeah, that was extreme. But we got through it, so that's all that matters. Maybe that'll break a little compaction up and dry it out. We'll see what happens. Definitely have to do something with it. I think there was a tile in that hole. Have to do some investigating out here, bring a little dig, and do some digging, and see if there is a broken tile through there. I know there's a lot of clay tiles on this farm. So we're going to have to do a little investigate and see what we can fix to make her a little better. But anyways, I'm about done with the second spot here. I'm going to hit this water hole a little more. I know it's not great practice to be discing through a water hole, but I'm trying to dry it out a little, see if I can break the crust and get some of that water to go away. I'm definitely going to bring a ripper down here after being out here. It's pretty hard. I think there's a compaction issue in some spots. I thought it was muck, but it must have, it is muck, but it must have a hard sand base under it that's not letting the water go through. So we're gonna do some extreme tillage out here and get some excavating equipment down here and see about some tiles and see if there's anything broken that we can fix easily, or get my buddy out here with his tile plow and just run in some 4-inch pipe and see if we can't get her drained. But anyways, I think I'm gonna end this episode of Dirt, Grain, and Steel. Pretty much you got the idea what's going on here. But anyways, if you made it this far in this video, thanks for watching. I greatly appreciate it. And I'll catch you on the next one. I greatly appreciate questions, comments, anything like that that you may have. And I hope you enjoyed it. So anyways, I'll talk to you later.